everybody. How you doing? Dr. Teresa Phillips here on the road. So we are on the road. We've just celebrated Christmas with our families and we're excited about God. Robert, say hello to everybody.
Hello, everybody. How you doing? Yeah, we're heading up there. We're doing a visit to my mother and my father, which is actually really pretty nice. It has been really nice season. Kind of odd for this time of year for Illinois anyway, but at least it's been nice. But thank God we've been blessed with warm weather. The only thing we're missing was blue water and white sand.
Yeah, that's true. Well, anyway, I just want to share with you that New Year's Eve, we are going to be having a New Year's Eve service at Kingdom Global Impact Center in St. Charles, Illinois. We do invite you out. It's from 7 to 9, so that gives you time to get home and celebrate the new year or whatever it is you're going to do. But, you know, God is really moving, and God is pouring out a lot of prophecy through a lot of the prophets. And I want you to be very tuned in to some of the things the prophets are saying, because some of it's going to be political. Let's face it, it's going to be political. Some of it's going to be really super, super spiritual. Some things we're going to understand, some things we're not going to understand. But one thing I know is that whatever God pours out, you're going to find the backing of it in the scriptures. And so today I want to encourage you, and I'm going to move my phone a little bit. I want to encourage you to be one of the ones that are hungry to go after what God is saying in the scriptures, so that when you release the word, or if you tell someone the word that you heard, you can back it up with scripture. Because right now God is looking for those ambassadors that are going to be having that realm of the spirit that God is moving through his scriptures, through his prophets. Now if you go to globalpropheticvoice.com, you will find the words out there that God has put. We have a word from Mahesh Shabda, and we've got one from Katie, and we've got one from myself about the kingship of Jesus, about the coronation time. This is because in 2020, in the next 10 years, we're going to see a lot about the royal priesthood. We're going to see a lot about kingship. We're going to see a lot about the priestly side of the church, the kingly side of the church. You know, God, it's a chosen generation. It's a chosen people that are going to be operating in this sphere of influence. And this sphere of influence, I just want to share this with you. And I'm sorry about the bouncing, but we're on that road. But this sphere of influence is really the pinnacle of what is the governance of the seven cultural spheres of influence. It's going to take kings and priests to establish the seven mountains and to move in those seven cultural spheres of influence. And it's going to take the kings and priests to become the ambassadors of the kingdom of heaven, so that we can move people up higher and stronger and with more courage and more anointing than they've ever had before, because we're living in the day of cultural war, spiritual warfare. And if we're going to talk more about the warfare than we are about the victory, we've already lost the battle. And so it's going to take the kings and the priests to bring the fivefold ministry into the order, so that the order of the kingdom of God, the great high priest Jesus, who is great high priest and king of kings, so that he can reign and rule through us, so that we can shift the church and help the nation. It's very important that we understand the concepts of kingship and priestly anointings and the priestly governance. And if you look those scriptures up in the word, you're going to find a whole lot in there that's going to give you an eye-opening revelation. So go to Global Prophetic Voice and the top three words that are on that front page. Read those words and study those words and look that over, because we're getting ready to move into that kingly priestly anointing. It's not here yet. There are a few people that I have met that actually carry it. But there, it's going to be a movement. It's going to be a mass movement over the next decade. So I just want to encourage you about that, because it should be something that excites us and ignites us. The realm of the king is very, very important. We don't understand it. We're Americans. We don't understand the concept of kingship. We don't understand the monarchical rule of the kingdom of heaven. We don't understand it. So get my book, The Monarchy of Heaven. It's on Global Prophetic Voice. You can find it. and just get it. You can even get it on Amazon. But it's important that we understand these spheres of influence, because God is getting ready to open up the heavens and pour out a glory we have never seen before. And it's going to be a time where there's really going to be a separation of the sheep and the goats. We're going to know those who are His and those that are not. And those that are not, ladies and gentlemen, we need to win them to Jesus Christ. You can say Jesus Christ. You can say a lot of things, but we really need to get people saved, sanctified, and filled with the Holy Ghost. And I'd like an amen from somebody on that. We really amen. Need to do that. Thank you, Robert. So I'm going to go now. We're on the road. We're heading up to deliver another Christmas stocking. For those of you that have been following us, we do have a charity out of our church called Be a Hero to a Hero. And that is Operation Gift of Vet is on this year. We have done around 800 stockings for veterans. We've gone to homeless shelters. We've gone to the police department. We've gone to the fire department. We have been delivering stockings like crazy. And we love it because this is what God's called us to do. So I'm going to say this again. Walk with the King. Find out about kingship. Go to Global Prophetic Voice and sign up for that. Subscribe to Global Prophetic Voice, because you're going to see a lot of stuff on there about kings and priests over the next few weeks. So God bless you. Have a happy new year. I hope you've had a blessed Christmas. And know that we do pray for our Facebook family and friends. God bless you. Bye-bye.